I will now demonstrate some common mistakes with single-handed knotting and how they can jeopardize knot security. To recap, a secure reef knot requires alternating coming down and going up throws, crossing the hands with each throw. What happens when one performs a throw without crossing their hands? You can see the threads do not lie parallel, reducing the friction and therefore the stability of the throw. Additionally, the threads are not in the correct orientation to form a reef knot. What if we perform the correct throw to begin with, but perform the same type of throw again? Here, I am performing two going up throws and despite crossing my hands, this does not form a reef knot. Another common mistake is knotting with a very stiff right hand. One may have the appearance of alternating coming down and going up throws with crossing, but because the thread in the right hand is steady, we actually knot around this, which is passing straight through the knot. Let me give you an example here. I perform a coming down throw and then a going up throw. But you can see the knot is actually formed around the white thread, and this has led to the formation of a slip knot that goes down but also is unstable and can come undone. Remember to always cross your hands to prevent this. Let's review the correct method for left-handed knotting. Remember, the type of throw depends upon the thread that you hold in your active left hand. Here, I have the down thread, so I perform a going up throw and cross my hands such that the down thread now lies up. This half hitch lays flat. Since I now have the up thread in my left hand, I perform a coming down throw with my left hand and cross my hands to create a secure reef knot.